This is the Blaring Out with Eric Blair show, and today we're at the 10th annual Tony Hawk Foundation Stand Up for Skate Parks event. So Eve, tell me what brings you out here to the Tony Hawk Foundation.
Well, I am my boyfriend, first of all. Maximilian is has been good friends with Tony for a long time. I got to meet Tony through Max, and I think is what he's doing is amazing. He's building in skate parks in inner city, you know, for inner city kids all over, actually. And I'm from Philly, and he's putting a skate park in Philly, and I think it's just amazing. I think it's great for kids.
Now, what have you been up to?
What have I been up to? I just finished an 8-city tour. I put out an album on my label. I'm independent now. It's called Lip Lock, so it's in stores. And I've been in some movies, and I have a movie called Bounty Killer that's out. And traveling like a crazy person. So, yeah, but all good stuff.
What makes Eve the happiest right now in her life?
I would have to say being home with my boyfriend back in London. So we live in London. So that makes me the happiest right now. Keeps me calm.
Is Eve a spiritual person?
Yes, I do. I guess so. I mean, I consider myself. I do believe in a whole big universe, and I talk to God and my angels. And so, yeah, I guess that makes me spiritual.
Now, one of the questions we ask is makeup must-haves. Ooh. What are your makeup must-haves? And name them.
Okay, makeup must-haves. Loose bronzer from MAC Cosmetics.
Okay.
Foundation from MAC Cosmetics. And powder from Laura Mercier. Must-have.
So you're using a liquid foundation from MAC with the and you're powdering it with the Laura Mercier.
Yes, exactly.
And that gives you the color and the coverage that you like.
For me, like I don't, because I'm not a professional in any sense of the word, but for like days like this that are light days, I feel like that helps. It's good for me. You know, professionals use more, but for me, that's perfect.
Yeah, you look fantastic. And then tell me, that's MAC lip gloss.
It's actually called Kinda Sexy, because that's how I was feeling this morning. But yeah, it's called Kinda Sexy from MAC.
And do you ever use a lip pencil?
You know, I don't, but I will leave that up to a professional if they think it looks better. But I don't personally know.
When do you think is a good time for a girl to wear red lipstick? When can she get away with it?
I think anytime. I think if you have the confidence, it's good day or night. If it's your thing, it's your thing. And I think you have to have the confidence to pull it off. That is the key to red lipstick. Just make sure you have the confidence to pull it off.
When is your key time to wear a red?
For me, I like it at night. So if I was doing, you know, going to an event, or if I had on like an all black situation, or I think red's just a perfect color. It's classic.
Do you prefer a blue base or a yellow base red?
Blue base is better for my skin tone.
Yeah.
I like all these questions. How do you know all this stuff?
I'm a makeup artist.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Blue base is better for my skin tone, I believe.
And then what about blush?
I don't always use it. I prefer bronzer.
Okay.
But I did today put a little bit over because I knew we were going to do pictures. And it's MAC.
How do you feel about filling in eyebrows?
And defining them? I think they're great as long as they're not too. Some people look better with really defined eyebrows. I don't. Mine look better when it's kind of, you know, kind of natural. And I use a pencil or sometimes a gel. So.
And then what is your number one hair product that you cannot live without?
At the moment, I am obsessed with all the Orbea. All the Orbea stuff, the dry shampoo, the salt shampoo for your hair, the soft lacquer is amazing and it smells great.
And then what is a hot artist that you love right now?
At the moment, who am I loving right now? Probably Kendrick Lamar.
Oh, everybody loves him. Everybody wants to duets with him and everything.
Well, he brought something exciting back to hip hop. I think he's saying some actual words. He's not just talking about strip clubs and Molly, and it's really nice.
And since you brought that up, what did you think of Miley Cyrus's performance at the VMAs?
I didn't watch it, but I think people should stop being shocked at this point.
I know. I mean, isn't that what the VMAs are for?
Right. She's the top of Billboard. She did something right. It made sense. No?
Do you think it's just a maturity thing for her where she's just growing up?
I think she had to do something drastic to take the image of her being a little kid at Disney out of people's minds. And I think at the end of the day, you know, why not? If you're going to go for it, go for it. And she did. So, and obviously it's working.
Now, we're seeing a trend with girls lately where they're not wearing pants, they're wearing G-strings. And that's to go to Walmart. I'm not joking. Okay, that's at Walmart. That's like at Sears, wherever. What do you think of that trend?
Put some damn pants on over your G-string. That is what I think of it.
You think that's wrong?
It's super wrong. Don't have your ass out at Walmart. Don't do that, y'all. This has to stop. This has to stop.
Eve, we love you. God bless you and have a beautiful day.
The Blaring Out Show.